Right, we're going to make a new sheath for a Mora Forester, which is a Swedish carbon steel, actually stainless steel, that says on it anyway. Swedish bushcraft knives. These are very, very popular knives because they're cheap. These cost, they're very inexpensive, sort of under £10. The reason they're cheap basically is because the handles and the sheaths are it's sort of just plasticky. They're not, you know, they're not, you know, getting like wooden handles or anything like that. But basically, you're paying for the blade, and the blades are very, very high quality. But because they're a bit cheaper, basically, when they break, you can kind of just replace them. They're a bit throwaway, really. But they are very, very, very popular, especially as a kind of beginner's knife. You know, if somebody doesn't want to spend sort of, you know, £100-200 on a custom bushcraft knife, often they can start out with a Mora like this. They're very, very well respected, and you know, very well recommended. These come in a really horrible plastic sheath with a plasticky clip on, so we're going to make a new sheath for this. Classic blue Peter style is one I prepared earlier. We're going to do the same as this again, but because, you know, I've already finished this one, I'm going to show you this one. It's a Kydex sheath body, Kydex fire steel loop. Pop your fire steel in there. Multiple positions on the fire steel loop. You can move it around the sheath if you like. Leather belt clip, which you can take off. And we've put on, there's also some horizontal leather, horizontal leather belt things there as well. So you can take the normal belt clip off, put the horizontal ones on and wear it that way if you like, or attach it to a pack or whatever you want to do. Obviously those same four Chicago screws there will you know, fit these two belt straps as well. So, the first thing we need to do is mark and cut out a piece of Kydex, which we're going to use for the forming. For this one, we're going to use this fetching kind of burgundy coloured Kydex. So, the way it's going to be done is it's going to be formed over the knife, and then it'll be trimmed off. So basically, you want some excess. So I'm just going to work out how much we need. I'm going to place the existing sheath on there. I'm going to work out about half of the size that I need, size wise. Make sure I've got enough excess on there. Mark down about half. And then basically I'm going to double that size. Obviously you need to account for the fact that it's got to go over the knife, and so on. The first time you make, if you make it more than one sheath, you can use the previous sheath to get the size. Obviously if it's the first time you're making a sheath, allow more rather than less Kydex, because if you make it too small, you're just going to have to start again, and it's not that expensive that you need to worry about having a, you know, a few extra square inches. So now the easiest way to cut Kydex is to score and snap when you're doing this. So obviously I could run this under a bandsaw, I could use a hacksaw, I could use a jigsaw, I could use all those different things. But basically the easiest thing to do is take a sharp knife, like a Stanley knife, score down your pencil lines. So we've scored that down, so basically we can now just bend that. And then as soon as we counter bend it, it's going to pop like that. Come down, bend it, and counter bend it. There we go. So the next thing we need to do is heat this. Now there's different ways that you can heat your Kydex. I'm going to use a hot air gun, which works okay. Some people tell you it doesn't work okay. It, you know, I used it for this, and that works fine, so it does work. You can put it in an oven, like your oven in your kitchen. You can use what the Americans call a toaster oven, in England you call them mini ovens, them little, you know, kind of square electric plug-in oven things. They do pies in them and stuff. Can use them. I've seen some people saying you can use like a griddle. You know, whatever you do, basically you're making it hot. I'm going to use a hot air gun. If you want to look at oven temperatures and work out how to do it in your oven, then there's plenty of things online about that. So what we're going to do is we're going to get a hot air gun, we're going to heat this over until it's all nice and floppy, and then basically I'm going to take this knife, so many knives I'm getting confused, this knife it's the same as that one, I've wrapped a couple of turns of masking tape around the blade just to thicken the blade up, not around the handle. The reason I've done that is when you form the Kydex around the blade, you don't really want that actually glove tight on the blade, because then every time you put the blade in, it's actually going to sort of rub up and down the blade, and it's going to offer friction and resistance and dull the knife edge and so on. You want just a little bit of a gap around it, so by putting the tape on and then forming around it, when you then take the tape off and put the knife back in, you've got that sort of, you know, quarter mil, half mil gap there, and it just gives the blade some space to move, and obviously it's not rubbing on the edge and so on. It's also a little bit safer for your fingers while you're doing the forming. So we're going to heat this up. I will then lay the knife on the Kydex like so, fold the Kydex over the knife, and we're then going to pop this into a Kydex press. Okay, I'm going to put my gloves on so I don't burn my hands. I've got the Kydex press there propped open with an awl, because once I get the Kydex warm enough, it's going to have to go in there really quickly, and the lid needs to close really quickly, and it needs to get pressure on really quickly, because as soon as the heat comes off this, it will start to solidify. So you've literally got maybe 5 to 10 seconds maximum once you take the heat off to actually get that into the press and closed up in order to form well. Otherwise it's not going to form. So before you start to do your heating, everything needs to be in place ready to do it quickly. If you do form it and it's not right, you can reheat it and have another go. That's the good thing about Kydex. You can reheat it, try again. So it's not a problem. You're only wasting time rather than materials. So I've got the heat gun ready. I've got the Kydex ready. I've made sure I know in my mind where on the piece of Kydex I need to actually place the knife, because you don't want to get this hot and then go, where did I need to put that? So I know that I know how far up the handle it needs to be, how far over it needs to be, and it wants to be something like that. Okay. One other thing, your Kydex is smooth on one side, textured on the other side. Okay, the textured side goes to the outside, the smooth side is the inside. So make sure you've actually got that the right way up as well, and you know which way you're going. Okay. So off we go. This won't take long to get hot. Be careful with you. If you're using a heat gun, the end of this will get really, really hot, as in, you know, burning your skin hot. So be mindful of where you're putting that at all times, and to keep it away from your skin. Okay, that's nearly there. Leave it 10 more seconds. It should be flexible enough that you can fold it over, and it doesn't try and spring back too much. Okay, there's a fine line between, if it starts to wrinkle, it's too hot. Alright, so it's quite a fine line. Okay, ready, off, knife up, position it, fold it over, make sure it's in the middle of the piece, into the press, right in there, all out, squash down, pressure on, locking chain up, lock into place. Okay. You can see that it's formed well around the handle there. You know, it's taken the shape of the handle well. It's followed the contours of the handle well, so you know it didn't get too cold before I put it in. If that was a kind of not well defined shape, you'd know that it had gone in too cold and it hadn't formed well to the contours. But because you can clearly see the outline of the knife there, you know that it's formed okay. So the next thing to do with this is going to be to mark basically where we want the rivets. Not rivets, eyelets. It's a bit confusing, is this? To me, they're eyelets. In England, that's what you call an eyelet. When you order them from America, they're called Kydex rivets, which to me, the rivets is where it's solid. So if I keep saying rivets and eyelets interchangeably, basically I'm talking about these, but you should call them eyelets, really, or I should call them eyelets. If you're American, you could call them rivets, so I don't really care. We're talking about these anyway. We're going to need to mark out where we want those. Now, the easiest way I found to do this is to tape it. So I'm just going to mark my actual edge distance, as in how far away from the knife and the blade I want that. Put my ruler on, give myself a straight edge relative to where the knife is there. Mark that. Okay, so what I've done there is I've marked obviously two parallel lines on the edge of the sheath. So before I position these eyelets, I'm going to need to just shape the top of the sheath, and that way there'll be as much Kydex there as there will be when it's finished, and I can work out quite where the eyelets need to go for the tensioning. So again, copying this one that I've already done, just going to work out about where I've actually brought the curve in, which is just across the... make sure obviously that you don't take too much off when you're doing only doing this part, because this is the part that's actually gripping the handle, so you know you need to make sure that you've still got that Kydex there to grip. So you can see that where I've brought the line across there, I've not taken anything off this section where it's actually coming in and getting behind that finger guard, which is what's doing the gripping. So I'm just going to go now and actually cut this part off. Alright, so I've just bandsawed the top of the sheath off there. There's obviously a little bit of an angle there which I'll sand off later. It just needs to be roughly that shape for now. So basically that knife will now slide in and out with, you know, it'll even shake out, and that's because there's actually no tension on the sheath. It's the eyelets that you put closest to the mouth of the sheath that provide the tension. So what you need to do is you need to work out where those eyelets need to be. Now, the easiest way to do that is to grip it in different locations until you feel that the tension is where it needs to be. You can take some clamps with a knife in the sheath. You can basically clamp over the edge of the Kydex. And what that will do is essentially simulate where the eyelets are going to be. And we can then pull the knife out. Take the actual knife now without the wrapping, and feel how secure that needs to be, and whether it clicks into place at different positions. And basically, the closer to the mouth of the sheath you move with this, the stiffer it'll be. So obviously, if it was right up there, it's going to be too stiff. So it's just a question of moving these backwards and forwards, looking where the leading edge of the clamps are, and just getting these to the point where you're comfortable with the retention. And obviously it shouldn't be too, you know, it shouldn't be too stiff, but it should also click into place there, and it shouldn't be wanting to shake out. Those eyelets will be essentially what provide the tension on the sheath. All the other eyelets that go around the edge are basically holding it together and will be positioned for your belt loops and you know, your tech locks or whatever you want to put on. But it's those leading couple of eyelets that actually set the tension, and they're the ones that are most important to place properly. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to mark where I want the rest of my eyelets around the edge there, and then we can actually put those in. Okay, I've marked the points around there, what I've done is I've drawn a parallel line to my edge line to put all my points on, so I know that I've got the same distance away from the edge for my eyelets. We're now going to go downstairs, drill these on a pillar drill. This is a quarter inch lip and spur wood bit. Basically it's got a point on, and the point goes and drills before the main drill bit starts drilling. These are kind of designed for doing like clean holes in wood, I think, but you use them on Kydex because it stops it chewing the Kydex up, and it's also very easy to get the, when you're doing your drilling, you get the point right on the mark that you've made, so that your holes are nice and accurate. Okay, so we'll go and drill these holes now. The holes drilled, look. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to, with a sharp knife, score along these outside lines, and then we can take the tape off. Okay, there we go. So you can see, got the lines scored around there, which is what we're going to trim to. Got the holes ready for the eyelets. Right, I've drilled these holes and scratched my line around the outside. Now the next step is going to be to actually put the eyelets into the holes and close the sheath up. But before we do that, we need to make sure that there's no bits of swarf or turnings or whatever you want to call them in the holes, and none inside the sheath. The reason being that when you put the eyelets in and close the eyelets up, that's going to nip the sheath together and clamp it shut, and if there's any bits of Kydex swarf in between the layers, that's going to stop that closing up properly, and it's going to give you like a gap on the edge, which isn't going to look very good. So I'm just going to actually sort of take my very sharp knife and just clean as best I can these holes out, and then I'm going to give it a run under the tap and give it a blow through with some air, and everything that I need to do just to get this as clean as possible. So the next thing we need to do is to actually fit these eyelets in. Now for your eyelets, I'm not going to go into a big discussion on this, but basically you need to pick a company that provides the eyelets and the dies, and kind of invest in the dies and the eyelets. This is a set of Knife Kits dies, and these are Knife Kits eyelets. So if you go to knifekits.com, you can buy this stuff. The eyelets themselves come in various sizes. You can see that says CKK88. The first number refers to the diameter, the second number refers to the length. Then you will find that the shaft of the Chicago screw there just fits nicely through the eyelet, so these are ideal for fixing on the with Chicago screws, anything you want to fix on, like your tech locks or your belt loops or anything like that. Okay, so we'll just align the two pieces there so that they come together, and then basically when we put the eyelets in, the eyelets do have they kind of look the same on both sides, but the side that you roll is never quite as good. So you work out what is the face inside of your sheath. So essentially, if that was primarily going to be a right-handed sheath, then if it was hanging on that side of your body, you'd be looking at that side there. So we'll class that as the good side as such. And then all you do really is just push the eyelets through the holes. And just push them in at various points, just to stop anything pulling out of kilter while we set the first few. So basically, we just pop the eyelet onto the spike there, and then just give a short tug And what that does is rolls the back of the eyelet closed like that. And then we just repeat that process on all of the other eyelets there. Short tug. There. So with all your eyelets fit into your sheath, essentially anything else on the outside now isn't doing anything, so we'll be able to trim that off in a minute. Obviously up until this point, because we've folded this over, this fold that we've got here in the Kydex is what's been keeping everything lined up until we got to the point where we've obviously put the eyelets in. Once we trim that off, the fact that these eyelets are here is holding the side together anyway, so that should be okay. You should also take your knife at this point and test fit it as well. Make sure that it, you know, it slots into place properly, it's not going to fall out. Yeah, give it the old shake test, make sure it's okay. Shouldn't be too hard to pull out though, you know. And it should basically just click nicely into place, pull out okay, click in and not fall out. You're good to go if that's what you're doing. There we go. So what I will do now is I'll go to the bandsaw and I'll trim close to these lines, but not actually to the lines. And then in terms of actually getting down to the lines, they'll be sanded on the belt sander, and that'll get us actually right down to the edge there, and then we can just sand the edge. Okay, that's just been sanded, as you've seen. Same as when you're sanding leather, it rubs up a kind of just a burr line, which needs taking off. So just very carefully go down the edge with a sharp knife. Just remove that burr. I nearly forgot I've drilled a little drainage hole in there as well. Look, I've taken as much swarf as I can off the outside, and I'm just giving it a little rub with this wet and dry, just staying away from the eyelets, obviously trying not to rub any of that coating off. Should be pretty smooth anyway from the sander, because with the heat of the sander it actually kind of melts the edge slightly, so should be a pretty smooth finish anyway, but just to finish it up. And then just finally, obviously, it's going to need again a good wash through in the sink, and a blow through if there's some compressed air available, just to make sure there's no bits left inside if possible. And just make sure they're nicely rounded. And then the final thing to do, obviously, is just to check that the retention is okay, and if anything is off with the retention. You can always try reheating this part of the sheath and, you know, squidging a little bit down if you need to. Ideally you shouldn't do that, but occasionally it might be necessary. If you only need to do a little bit, like say you wanted to pinch up this bottom section, get a wet cloth with cold water on and cover all the parts that you don't want to heat with the wet cloth with the cold water, and just leave exposed the bit you want to heat. Put a bit of directed heat on with your air gun, and then you should just be able to nip up that little piece without losing the forming on the rest of it. As I say, ideally, once it's formed, you should leave it and not be reforming it. But it, you know, if you finish the whole sheath and you find it does need a slight adjustment, then you know, it's better to adjust it and have it right than say, you know, refuse to adjust it and try and use it with problems. So I've carved a little bit round either side with my craft knife of this top loop, and then I'm just gonna wrap the paper around it as best I can. Just make sure that this mouth part's smooth. You can also just feel with your finger whether they're smooth or not as well. You should be feeling okay. Keep your wet and dry paper wet. And just make sure that that's as good as you want it. Okay, I think that's alright. So I'm going to give this a rinse through, make sure the retention's okay, should be fine. And then just make the leather bits, and that's done.